you create your new project so that for before we come back next week. So having set up everything, so now you need to create your project. So what do you need to do? So first thing, as most of you must have seen, you just click on create new project. Then we are going to be using Maven project. We are going to be using Maven project, and you click on Maven project basically, and leave the create artifact unchecked. I just leave it like that and click on next. So, and enter your group ID. So whatever you want. So normally it will be name of your organization that you're testing. You can put the test or something like that to show that it's a test environment. And your ID, you put the ID, whatever you want to call your project, and you click on next. That should create the project for you. So that is where we're going to stop today. I'm going to go through that, do that for you. Then, okay, one, create new project. So, and we are going to be doing Marvin. So, next time we'll still look into creating it from artifacts. So we're going to look into artifacts. So maybe that is when you go your TestNG artifact. That should be easy for you. You got everything set up. But for tonight, we just want to say, okay, we are not creating from archetype. So we're going to call just create nest. So what you just need is, okay, what's the name of that particular? Okay, don't worry. What is the name of the applications? So what's your group ID, your artifact ID? Like I've proposed here, is basically the same thing. Your group ID, it will be that. So let me say, so project name. Say Blue Sky Training 2001. Okay, so location, I want to change it to a different location so I can change that. I want it to go into my Blue Sky stuff. I want to open a new want it to be in this particular location. So this is going to be my com dot phrase. This is basically how it happens. In a normal scenario, when you go to a site, you say test.giftreach.com, live.bluesky.com, api.bbc.com. So, but when you are creating your group ID, it's going to be like basically like you are writing Arabic, starting from the end to the first, basically. So that is the concept. So I'm testing giftreach.com and I'm creating a test environment for that particular test. So that's what I'm going to do. And your version is 1.0 snapshots. So then that will be it. So if I move this to the top, you then click on finish. So that should create your workspace. Okay, so that is your workspace. So technically it's going to create a POM folder for you. So this I'm going to quickly explain to you. So because we are going to be using POM folder. Last week I explained what a POM folder is, and I'm quickly going to explain this also quickly for you. So before we go into re-automation from next week. Now, this is basically your IntelliJ IDE. So, and full is basically IntelliJ IDE. So you have your menu at the top, right? So you have your file. IntelliJ is technically auto-save, so you don't need to save. It's going to be saving this for you automatically. You need to know that. But as well, you can save all your folder open. You got that facility, and you have your settings as well. So peradventure, you want to change anything after you can see this is also where you can actually check, because before now I use it configure your environment, your IntelliJ before opening it. But peradventure, you missed it. You just go to file and go to settings from here. That should do that for you. So you can as well open new projects. So for instance, if I want to open another project, you just go to file and you click on new. Or if you want to open a new one, I'm going to show that to you because it's very, very important to know. It's different than how you open Visual Studio Code or Visual or any other projects. You need to know what you need to open. So I'm going to go through this also. So quickly, so you can open recent projects, you can close the project, you can go to your project structure that I think I've showed this to you also. So you can still see those things in file basically. Or you want to manage your IDE settings, and you got your what I've showed to you before, your upstream and everything. So you don't need to worry about this one for now. So, and yeah, so that is basically what, and of course you can print, you can export. So then and edit, you have everything that you can do on that document, copy and paste, delete and everything, undo. So, and also redo. So that this is what this one is for. Or if you want to do indent and as well view, you want to sh appearance and everything. So, and your code as well, you can move to the next element, move to the up and down. So that's it's there for you. Touring. So we as we move along, I'm going to talk about this later. So this is very important. So for those guys that are comfort knows for those guys that know how Visual Studio works, and you want to say I want to build my project, the same application, the same concept is IntelliJ. You can build your project. I'm also going to tell you how to do that using Maven as well. So your tools to save your template and everything, so you don't need to worry about those ones. So and yeah, one thing that you're going to be using more often is this side of your project, which is we are not going to use Ant, we are going to use Maven to build your project. So or more often than not, so you're going to come here and click on Maven. So once you click on Maven, you expand your project. So you can then click on Lifecycle. On clean is basically for you to clean your project. That is going to remove all your jars, and then after that, compile everything. You can click on compile or validate. So we're going to be using this more often. So, but more often you will clean and also maybe compile your project again, and we're going to see all this in actions. And you have your project, your plugin. Yeah, so it's very, very important. Let me close this one. So it's very important to always check your plugin in to ensure that you don't have any red alerts here. So everything should be kind of green, everything is kind of done like that. So it's very, very important. So then at this point also, if you come here, you can see some people will fret because they are not seeing that project structure. So you just need to come here and click on your project structure, and that you can have your files here. So your project is structured in different folders. This is the top part of your project. You don't need to worry about the external libraries. It is not your, you don't care about them. So to be honest, you don't need to worry. So this is this one that you need to worry about. That's where you need to look into. Click on that. Dot idea, you don't need to worry about that. It is not your business. So, and then the most important part, it starts from the SRC and as well as the POM. So your POM is your like basically like a configuration file for you. I will explain this in a few moments. So but now you have your main and you have your test. So this is very, very important to know what they do. So as a developer, since this course is not for developer, it's for QA or automation tester. So, but I'm going to explain this. So if you're working in a team, your developers would put their code in the main folder. So it's going to go into the Java folder residing on main. But as a tester, you are going to be storing your files into the Java part of the tester. So your Java code will go in there. But however, you might also create other resources folders, but everything that you are going to be creating will be on this particular package test. The package for the developers are going to be in the main, while your packages are, yeah, they are going to, your package is going to be in the test environment, on the test package, yeah. So that is that. So, and you put all your four files there. So the next one is your POM. As you can see, this is a POM. So what we have there, we have kind of, it's like an XML, basically, it's basically an XML file. So starting from XML, your project. So you don't need to worry about these top ones. It's none of your business. And so that is that. So you can see your group ID is what you have here. And your Artifact ID, the one that we put there is there, basically your project name and your snapshot. So basically this is from the text box that we entered before and just supplied everything. That is your POM. So, but we are going to be expanding this to include other things that are required. So I will be letting you know as the time goes on. So that is basically it for now. So, and any question before I pass you over to the admin for anyone that's got any issues. Okay, can I please explain how to write your code to launch a browser? So we are not there yet. So I think by next week or 2 weeks, you should be able to get to that point. So yeah, so that is the focus of this particular course actually, but we are not there yet actually. So if that makes sense. So from next week, it's going to be like now. We got every environment set up done. We got all the system done. So from next week, we are going to go very fast. So, and writing the automation from scratch, clicking website, browsing website, and yeah. And that will be it. Okay. So, and from next week, when we're going to start from this location, and then we'll push our code to Git basically. So that is what we will start from.